Welcome to another Audible article from MindPower, CenterPoint's free weekly email newsletter. Every Monday, MindPower brings you inspirational articles from leaders in the personal development field, useful tips and techniques to improve your life, plus CenterPoint news and updates. See the links below for more information about this week's MindPower. This week's article is The Lazy Person's Way to Effectively Break Bad Habits, written by Bill Harris, read by Mark Gilson. Here's the deal. There's a battle going on inside a part of the brain responsible for habitual action and goal-based action. The orbitofrontal cortex, to be precise, but I didn't want to make your eyes glaze over. When the orbitofrontal cortex is in active mode, you'll easily set and achieve goals. When it's underactive, you'll be in habitual mode. Scientists learn how to artificially adjust orbitofrontal cortex activity in mice. When activity increased, goal-based action increased. When activity decreased, habitual action took over. Both habitual action and goal-based action have their role. Consider these common activities: driving to work or washing your hands. You don't have to think about them to make them happen. You do them automatically. This is your brain's autopilot. If you've ever habitually turned toward home when you actually meant to go somewhere else, you've experienced autopilot mode. Habitual action can be extremely useful. Routines allow us to accomplish simple tasks without thinking about them. For instance, brushing your teeth. When a new element is introduced, brushing your teeth when you've had dental surgery, habitual action won't work. We need to switch to goal-based action. This switching from one mode to the other isn't always easy, though. We want to use the best method in every situation. Sometimes a habit involves a thought, idea, desire, or outcome. Examples include anything from biting your nails or compulsively checking Facebook to addictions and disorders like obsessive-compulsive disorder. Obsessive-compulsive or addictive behavior is caused in part by the brain's inability to switch from habitual to goal-based actions. The brain's gear shifter is the anterior cingulate. When the anterior cingulate works well, you're more cooperative, you have cognitive flexibility, you see options, and you go with the flow. When the anterior cingulate is stuck, you get stuck. You have trouble transitioning from one option or way of thinking to another. Now, there's one more part of the brain we need to look at, the caudate, a part of the limbic system. The caudate is responsible for the emotional tone you attribute to whatever's happening. When the caudate is overactive, you tend to catastrophize what's happening. You see danger, even if there is none. The caudate makes it difficult to avoid thinking about what you're stuck on. This is why just don't think about it is bad advice. After all, if there's danger, you'd better be stuck on it. Unfortunately, the caudate is capable of seeing danger where there is none. People with obsessive-compulsive disorder have overactive anterior cingulates and overactive caudates, and underactive prefrontal cortexes. If you've been trying to break bad habits without success, these parts of your brain may be to blame. Balancing your brain won't make your bad habits disappear overnight, but it will make it easier for your anterior cingulate to shift from habitual to goal-based mode. It will also make it easier to break bad habits and form new good habits. So, how do we optimize brain function? Well, that's a good question. First, you can try supplements. 5-HTP increases serotonin levels. Low serotonin is associated with obsessive-compulsive disorder, depression, and anxiety. St. John's wort also increases serotonin in the brain. GABA calms activity in the limbic system. L-theanine, this is another calming supplement. It reportedly increases alpha waves in the brain. Glycine. Glycine calms brain activity in several areas, including the anterior cingulate and the caudate. Inositol is another serotonin booster. What are some other methods for optimizing brain function? Well, there's exercise. Research shows that short 1 to 4 minute bursts followed by a rest period repeated several times are more effective than longer periods of less intense exercise. What about breathing? Well, slow breathing calms the limbic system. Nutrition? Diets that are high in protein, low in carbs, and high in good fat, coconut oil, avocados, butter, omega-3s, extra virgin olive oil, keep the limbic system calm. Sleep? 7 to 8 hours of sleep a night helps keep the limbic system calm. And meditation. Countless studies show that meditation calms the limbic system and enhances the prefrontal cortex. Now, the problem with meditation is that few people actually are willing to do it. Meditation is hard to learn and takes a long time to see significant results. But thankfully, it's now possible to create the same brain changes as traditional methods in a fraction of the time, using a technological approach. Centerpoint's Holosync technology does exactly that. Using combinations of pure sine wave audio tones delivered to the brain through stereo headphones or earbuds, Holosync creates the brainwave patterns of an experienced 30-year meditator. Holosync is the easier way to meditate. All you do is listen. There's no learning curve. Now, to experience the brain-changing power of Holosync for yourself, try our 5-day Holosync challenge. The 5-day challenge is fun, it's free, it takes just a few minutes a day, and you'll also be able to connect with our support team if you've got any questions. Click the link in the description for more details and to register. Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed this article, please like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, be well.